Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. In the name of Allah, the most compassionate, the most merciful. A complete hadith from Sahih al-Bukhari regarding some of the grave punishments for some of the major sins and of overall sins. O Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, save us from all punishments of Akhirah and the hellfire, and make us die as a true Muslim whenever our death. Ameen ya Rabbul Alameen. Allahumma inni a'uzubika minal azabil khabri wa minan azabil jahannam wa min fitnati mahiya wa mamati wa min sharri fitnati masiya tajjal. Ameen ya Rabbul Alameen. Sahih al-Bukhari narrated Samura bin Jundub. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam very often used to ask his companions, did anyone of you see a dream? So dreams would be narrated to him and by those whom Allah wished to tell. One morning, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, last night two persons came in my dream and woke me up and said to me, proceed. I set out with them and we came across a man lying down, and behold, another man was standing over his head holding a big rock. Behold, he was throwing the rock at a man's head, at the man's head, injuring it. The rock rolled away and the thrower followed it and took it back. By the time he reached the man, his head returned to the normal state. The thrower then did the same as he had done before. I said to the two my companions, Subhanallah, who are these two persons? They said, proceed. So we proceeded and came to a man lying on his back and another man standing over his head with an iron hook. And behold, he would put the hook in one side of the man's mouth and tear off and the that side of his face to the back of the neck, and similarly tear his nose from front to back and his eyes from front to back. Then he returned to the other side of the man's face and did the same thing. On other side, he hardly completed this side when the other side returned to its normal state. Then he returned to it and repeat the thing that what he had done before. I said to my two companions, Subhanallah, who are these two persons? They said, proceed. They said, proceed to me. And we proceeded and we came across something like a tanur, a kind of baking oven, a pith, usually clay lined for baking bread. I think the Prophet said in that oven there was a noises and voices. The Prophet added, we looked into it and found naked men and women, and behold, the flame of a fire was reaching to them from beneath, and when it reached them, they cried loudly. I asked them, who are these? They said to me, proceed. So we proceeded and came across a river. I think he said, blood-like river is that. Prophet added, and behold, in the river there was a man swimming, and on a bank there was a man who had collected many stones. Behold, while the other man was swimming, he went near him, and farmer opened his mouth, and the latter on the bank threw a stone into his mouth, whereupon he went swimming again. He returned, and every time the performance was repeated. I asked my two companions, who are these two persons? They replied, proceed and proceed. And we proceeded till a till we came to a man with a repulsive appearance. The most repulsive appearance we ever saw a man having. Beside him there was a fire, and he was kindling it and running around it. I asked my companion, "Who is this man?" They said, "Proceed and proceed." We proceeded till we reached a garden with a deep green dense vegetation, having all sorts of spring colors. In the midst of the garden there was a very tall man, and I could hardly see his head because of his great height, and around him there were children such a large number as I had ever seen. I said to my companions, "Who is this?" They replied, "Proceed and proceed." So we proceeded till we came a majestic huge garden, greater and better than I ever seen. My two companions said to me, "Go up," and went up. The Prophet added, "So we ascended till we reached a city built of gold and silver brick, and we went to its gate and asked the gatekeeper to open the gate, and it was opened. And we entered the city and found in it men with one side of their bodies as handsome and as the handsome most person you have ever seen, and the other side as ugly as the ugliest person you have ever seen." My two companions ordered those men to threw themselves into the river. Behold, there was a river flowing across the city, and its water was like milk with whiteness. In whiteness, those men went and threw themselves into it, and then returned to us after the ugliness of their bodies had disappeared, and they become in the best shape. The Prophet further added, "The two companions are angels," and said to me, "This palace is the Eden paradise, and that is yours palace." I raised my sight, and behold, there I saw a palace like a white cloud. My two companions said to me, "That palace is yours palace." I said to them, "May Allah bless you both. Let me enter." They replied, As for now, you will not able to enter it, but you shall enter it one day." I said to them, "I have seen many wonders tonight. What does all that means which I have seen?" They replied, "We will inform you. As for the one man who came upon whose head was being injured with the neck, is the symbol of one who studied the Quran and neither recited it nor acted upon its orders, and sleeps neglecting the obligatory prayers. As for the man you came upon, whose side of mouth, nostrils, eyes were torn off from front to back, he is the symbol of a man who goes out his house in the morning and tells so many lies that it spread all over the world. And those naked men and women who you saw in the construction resembling an oven, they are the adulterers and adulteresses. And the man whom you saw swimming in the river, which is blood like and given the stone to swallow, is the eater of usury, that is riba. And the bad looking man whom you saw near the fire kindling it and going around it is Malik and the gatekeeper of the hell. And the tall man whom you saw in the garden is Ibrahim alayhi salam, and the children around him are those children who die in fitra, Islamic faith, fitra, the narrated added, some Muslim asked the Prophet, "O Messenger of Allah, what about the children of pagans?" The Prophet replied, "And also the children of pagans." And in that also the children of pagans, Prophet added, "My two companions added, the man you saw, half handsome and half ugly, were the persons who had mixed an axe that was good and with the another that was bad, but Allah forgave them." Alhamdulillah.